Had a lot of coffee. I'm trying to maintain. And by coffee, I mean powerful hallucinogens. Did you know, by the way, you know that the wasabi sauce that you get in the sushi? You know if you eat like a pound of that in one go, it's hallucinogenic? Did you know that? I mean, it's not true, but if that was true... No, actually, that is true. But the only thing is, it's a very high price for a hallucination. CBS in no way endorses the use of wasabi sauce as a hallucinogen. Please don't do it. CBS cares. Oh, by the way, hey, have you seen the new CBS logo thing? They've got this new thing to promote all the new shows for the new. It's called Only CBS. And I'm like, yeah. That's like what happened when I got this job. They went, good news, you got a late night talk show. Bad news, it's only CBS. What are you gonna do? We'll be back with one of the greatest, most scripted, high budget shows in television. Oh, wait, no, we won't.
Craig Ferguson.
Hey! Look at you. Come on in. Hi, everybody. Welcome. That's enough. People will begin to suspect we've used performance-enhancing drugs on the audience. And we have. The greatest performance-enhancing drug in the world. Free candy. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. No, it's... And that's because it's, of course, it's Friday. Hooray! I gotta tell you, this is true. I drank an awful lot of coffee yesterday, Thursday. And so I'm still kind of like, oh. And then I think I'm going to get a bit weepy towards the end of the show. Stick around. Stick around if you want to see a grown man cry. You want to see that, don't you? You want to see it because you're bad. Bad in a way that drives women crazy. Oh. Hey, you know what? I have to say this weekend, happy birthday to my friend Drew Carey, who turns 51 tomorrow. Happy birthday, Drew. God bless you. A fine man, a fine American, Drew Carey. And I hope his birthday party turns out better than last year's, because last year Drew ate the giant birthday cake, but the stripper was still inside. We're still paying the family, it's so. Do you hear that? The Japanese astronauts, and I think I speak for us all when I say the Japanese have astronauts. Yes, they do. They've tested a flying carpet in space. I don't know how the Japanese flying carpet works, but already it's outselling American flying carpet. That doesn't even make sense. Hey, the you know what I'm excited about this weekend? The movie Night at the Museum 2 opens today. And, yeah, today, Friday, that's right, yeah. Shut the hell up! You want to tell anyone about Santa Claus? Want to do that now, do you? All right, anything you want to say about the Easter Bunny, the Tooth Fairy? Go right on! Yeah. Don't you worry, of course it's Friday. Anyway, they've already announced the sequel to Night at the Museum 3. No, Night at the Museum 2. There's a sequel, Night at the Museum 3. Oh, who cares? Night at the Museum 3 will take place in a new location filled with dusty old relics of the past. A car dealership. Yappy, I've done your damn joke. Now can I get on? Thank you. Now, Night at the Museum... You didn't even try with that joke. I know. I wanted to like the joke, but I could not like the joke. The joke was dry. I knew it was coming. I was like, oh, God, here comes the joke. Oh, God. Here comes the joke. There's the joke in the audience. An otherwise fantastic studio audience are kind of like, oh, what the hell is that? Jeez, that's the worst joke ever. They're like, oh, I know. And that joke was written by a professional. Anyway, Night at the Museum isn't the only movie opening this weekend. The Terminator, I'm very excited. The Terminator Salvation movie opens and people are like, who will win? And I'm like, who gives a rat's ass? But I'm sure they're both good. But the one I'm more excited about, I mean, the Night at the Museum is a great movie. I love that movie. But the Terminator, it's the Terminator. And Arnold isn't in this one. He's too busy terminating the state of California.
What happened to you, man? Education for children, who needs it? Oh. Give me boobies.
I wish Arnold Schwarzenegger would leave California alone and go back to the movies, because the new robot in the new Terminator movie isn't as scary as Arnold was. The robot in the new movie isn't threatening at all. Really. Do we have a trailer of the new movie? Look at this.
We are outnumbered by machines.
This thing is something we've never seen before.
It's not that scary. I'm excited about the new Terminator movie. This is the movie where when they were shooting it, Christian Bale went crazy on the set. Remember that? He went all shouty and it was like, ah, you, and why I oughta boop, and you oughta boop, and I heard it. And I remember when I heard the recording, I'm like, this is awesome. I love this guy. And people are all up in arms, oh, Christian Bale screamed and swore on a movie set. And I'm like, well, I don't think he screamed and swore enough. If you haven't heard an actor screaming and swearing on a movie set, it's because you haven't spent enough time on a damn movie set. That's why. Actors are douchebags and a movie set is a high-pressure environment. It's true. You've got this actor here. This is a terrific actor, Christian Bale, and you're giving him millions of dollars, right? And you're paying him millions of dollars to be emotionally unstable, to be a kind of conflicted guy like that. And then, while he's in the middle of this high-pressure situation and being all conflicted, he has a tantrum. And everybody's like, he's emotionally unstable. And I'm like, that's why you're paying him millions of dollars! It's crazy! That man's a good actor. This is, I mean, complain, it would be like hiring me to come out here and ramble for 10 minutes about rubbish and then saying, oh, he doesn't make any sense. I'm like, I know that's my trademark. I don't make any sense. You want sense? You want a late night show with sense? There's plenty of them. They walk out, the band's playing, oh, you the man, no, you the man. Oh, blah, blah, oh, the joke about the thing that the guy wrote for him, yaggity, yaggity, yak. Then the guest comes out and they all go through the questions they've been talking about all day. The most spontaneous thing you will see is the ShoutWow commercial. Call me Christian. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big show that where no expense is spared and making everything so great. And hey, the band, any music for that? Oh, no. Of course, you don't have any music for that, do you? Because you don't exist. Only CBS. Yeah, you're going to regret that. Suits upstairs. Yeah, that's right. I strike fear into the heart of the CBS executives. Many of whom have heard of me. All right. This is from Phyllis in Saratoga Springs in New York. One of the most beautiful horsey towns in America. If you need to buy a horse, get yourself to Saratoga Springs where there's hundreds.
I was thinking of buying a horse.
Where are you?
Well, let's go to Saratoga.
All right, then. It's a little play I like to put on sometimes because I have nothing else. This is from Phyllis in Saratoga Springs. She says, Craig, what do you think about all the new TV shows that CBS is going to put on the air next season? I'm really curious. When she says, I'm really curious, do you think that's to do with her question? Or she's just telling you how curious she is? Like, I'm really curious. I'm a 15-foot-tall Asian woman with a lot of tattoos. And I'm like, whoa, that's pretty curious. Like, yes, a lot of people think so. No, she says, what do I think of the new CBS shows? They're all fantastic. Oh, they're all so great and entertaining and better than anybody else's shows, and I'm a whore. Here's an interesting question. This is from Nancy in Montreal, which is part of Canada that the Canadians can't get to speak English. Would you guys mind speaking English, eh?
No.
Nancy says, Dear Craig. Oh, she probably says it like this. Dear Craig. In some books, why do they have blank pages at the very end? Well, I get asked this a lot, Nancy, usually by... Why they leave blank pages at the end of books is so if you don't like the ending, write another one. You know, so like when at the end of perhaps, what's it called? Gone with the Wind, you know, and he says, frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. You could add a little bit more. Make it better. Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. What's to say we don't go and have some lunch and talk it over, Scarlett? And Scarlett's like, you don't own me, Rhett Butler. And he's like, oh, come on, Scarlett, I respect you as a woman. And she's like, oh, okay. And then they go to IHOP and he has the pancakes and the Colorado omelet. And she's like, I'm watching my weight. And he's like, you don't have to. You look great, girlfriend. At the end of the book, you know, jazz it up, make it better than the crap it is at the moment. I don't know. This is from Amy in Apple Valley in Minnesota. There's an Apple Valley in California, you know, as well. You can probably see it out that photograph there. Do we have a photograph at Apple Valley? Oh, no, we don't. No, we don't have a photograph. What we have is a sort of photograph of nothing. Man, I'm getting really bolshy these days. Dear Craig, says Amy, do you have any plans for Memorial Day weekend? Yes, I do. This is from Serena in Salem in Massachusetts. Let me just add that Serena is not a witch. You don't want to be a witch in Salem. I think you know what I'm saying. Hey, it was Sabrina the teenage witch, wasn't it? Oh, wouldn't it have been great if her name was Sabrina? Hang on a minute. This is from Sabrina, and it's from Sabrina in Salem, Massachusetts. Oh, Sabrina the Teenage Witch! Ah! Oh no, you're the man. Sabrina says, "Dear Mr. Ferguson, do you have a favorite punctuation mark? I do! Exclamation point." For me, my favorite punctuation mark is the colon. Not the semicolon. The full colon. The dirtiest of all punctuation marks. All right, we got to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. Somebody was asking me during the break, a made-up person that I invented asked me during the break, what's this part of the tie called? That's known as the, that part of the tie. This part of the tie is known as the Scotsman, and this part is the Englishman. You see? I don't know why they became known as that. I think it's something to do with genitalia. My next guest is an actor, but one of the good ones. Oh, curse my foul mouth. He's in the new film, The Brothers Bloom, which is in theater starting May the 22nd. Take a look at this.
They're less painful ways to cut into a mark, you know?
Wink, 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 wink.
It's going to be the 7.9. Keep your head in the game. A Japanese judge is very tough. Up.
No, they're fantastic.
Can I turn my chair?
Yeah, you want to turn your chair?
Just a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. There we go. You want to turn it around?
Yeah.
There you go.
It's so heavy.
No. I know. Yeah, but are you all right? You comfortable there?
I'm a little nervous.
Really? Are you nervous about this?
Yes.
It's not a proper talk show. Why are you nervous? You were nervous the last day. Look, if you go on Leno, be nervous. Go on Letterman, be nervous. You come here, you're doing us a favor. Relax.
I got a little cotton mouth.
Oh, you've got cotton mouth. Oh, you're high.
Yes,
that's okay.
Very.
That's okay. That's hey, do you like this?
Yes. Whoa. Yeah. I had some of the wasabi that in the green room.
Oh yeah, yeah. Did you hear? Oh, it's okay now. No, knock it off.
Can you put that down?
No, sorry. Have you heard that rumor about wasabi that if you eat like a pound of it, you go nuts?
No, but I'm going to get some.
No, stop, Mark. You mustn't.
No, that's bad. No.
How are you doing?
We don't
right?
condone that kind of thing.
No. CBS cares.
It only cares.
Yeah, only CBS cares.
Cares.
Everybody, yeah, that's what they should say. Only CBS cares. Everybody else hates you. Yeah. Hey, how's the movie? Is it any good?
Like you.
And look, I mean, they loved it. They loved it, man.
Wow. I'm a whore.
Yeah, oh, me too.
I'm a whore.
Oh, by the way, when I said that,
it's amazing. It's wonderful.
Yeah.
I'm a whore.
Right, no, that's right.
It is. It actually is great and amazing and wonderful.
It looks
and
pretty
funny.
Good, actually.
It's fun.
It's funny and
it's
different.
Funny.
Yeah, yeah.
We need some funniness in the world right now.
Yeah, I would think. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah.
So, the last time you were here, which was a while ago.
That's right.
You
have a new set.
I do, yeah. You like it?
It's the whole Los Angeles.
No. This is a photograph of Reno.
Oh, it is. I recognize some of the places.
Yeah, yeah. Have you ever been to Reno, by the way?
I have, God forbid.
Yeah. I always was met with kindness and politeness by, you know, people in Reno. But I always felt like saying to them, whoa. I mean, come on.
It's a tough town.
It's pretty tough, yeah. It's
they have a huge pawnbroker industry there.
Yeah, pawnbrokers and bail bonds. That's how you know you're in a classy neighborhood.
Yes.
Bail bonds, checks cast, pawnbrokers. Where are you from?
Kenosha, Wisconsin.
Oh, very nice, yeah.
The mean streets of K-Town.
Kenosha, is that where... No, it's Oshkosh where they have the big airplane thing in Wisconsin. You ever heard of that? Oshkosh?
Mars Cheese Castle. The Cheese Castle.
The Cheese Castle?
The cheese nut log was invented
cheese
there.
Cheese nut log? You can't say cheese nut log on CBS. What's wrong with you?
Is it referring to genitalia, you think?
It is now.
Oh, if only we cared.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you care much about stuff?
What?
I care about some stuff. Yeah. I care about some stuff.
I do care about. Yeah. There's a lot I care about.
You care about your kids.
I care about my kids. My wife.
About my wife, too. That's about it, though.
What's left for us?
Well, there's always...
acting.
No, listen.
I want to talk about this now.
No, well...
No! Damn it!
All right. No. We only have that one! Don't throw stuff around here. This is all we have. It's not like we... It's not like we've got a store of other stuff lying around. This is it.
What? Have we been downgraded?
The minute I arrived on this show, the whole network was downgraded.
If only.
Yeah.
CBS.
Only CBS?
If only.
If only CBS. We've come full circle. You know we're out of time. You know that.
Yeah. We're out of time now?
Yeah.
I didn't even get to say anything.
You did? Yeah, you did.
I'm sure you did.
You said tons of stuff.
I had a whole thing about acting.
Oh, yeah, let's talk about acting. People love that. let's have an actor talking about acting. Whoa! No, acting's is cool, you know.
I look at acting like a man... who's in love with a beautiful woman who doesn't quite love him back the same way.
Mark Ruffalo, everybody!
Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back to The Big Show, where tonight I've finally decided to reveal my expertise in karate. I don't know how to do it. I just like saying karate. Welcome, Mr. Bond. Do you know karate?
Yes, I've heard of it.
My next guest is an actress and a writer. Ooh la la. You probably know her from The Office, which is a great show on Thursday nights on NBC. Mindy Kaling, everybody, Mindy Kaling.
Writer that I was ooh la la after writer.
Well, I was impressed.
I know, but he was like, oh, I guess I'm fancy.
Yeah, you are fancy. You're ooh la la.
It doesn't feel like a fancy job. So that's, I was like, oh, I guess I'm the queen.
You are. You're the queen.
I should have more of an attitude then about being a writer. Because.
No. No, it's good though. It's impressive. You're right. You're what they call the triple threat. You write, you act, and you look just sensational. But let me tell you this, there's only one queen on this show, Biet. And she's drinking from the snake mug. Now, I hear you're going to Vegas. We have to get through this quickly. You're heading off to Vegas, even although it's, what, 1:30 in the morning?
I pack my days. My day at 2 a.m. is when I start. No, I've never been to Vegas. I'm really excited. It's my birthday.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Listen, if you got a piece of paper, I'll write down a couple of places I think you should go.
I'm so excited for suggestions.
Yeah, right. Well, I'll just tell you.
Okay.
Lovett's Frozen Custard next to the Stratosphere.
I'm sorry, a custard place?
Oh, yeah.
For suggestions? I thought you were going to be like this club, this steakhouse, the girls are the hottest here.
Look at me.
Okay, what dessert place should I go to for Vegas on my birthday?
Lovett's Frozen Custard next to the Stratosphere. Look, if I go into a club, it's no longer hip. Just by me turning up. If I turn up, they go, crap, we're out of business. Look, he's here. I'm the anti-hip person.
Is there a convenient mart that you like that you want me to go to? Is there a church that you're fond of that I should be visiting?
I don't like to pick favorite churches. Not on TV, not a good idea. What church did he say he liked? Does he like another church better than my church? Best not to. So what are you going to do in Vegas then, apart from get custard?
Well, I'm going with my four single girlfriends.
Oh, that is so great.
We like know that it's sort of like so cheesy to do it, but I made these plans when I was single, like months ago, and now I have a boyfriend, and I'm like the only one of us that has a boyfriend.
You're the one I always hook up with.
But I don't know.
Back in the day, I'm married now, it's not the same, but you know.
But it's like, he's like a little like, so you're just gonna go to Vegas with your four single friends who have all been like, all we're gonna do is drink and party and meet guys.
Sure.
And I'm like, I'm not interested in that, baby. Like, I just want to go to hang out and turn my birthday. I don't want to say how old I am. You know what I mean? And, like, I feel like I'm being kind of a bad girlfriend. I kind of want to invite him. But that's lame, right?
No, it's not lame. Hey, knock it off, girls who... girls who are trying to get her relationship to fail so you can steal her man. You know that's what you're about. You do, but, you know.
I'm mistrustful now. Wait, so would you think that was weird if your girlfriend did that with, and you'd just be like, you would be like, take me with you. Like, what are you supposed to do?
No, I, that would be a bit needy, saying take me with you. I think what I'd do is I would go somewhere else, myself. Maybe Bangkok with some guy. Maybe me and the guys would go to Bangkok for the weekend. It's nothing, baby. I'm just going with my friends to Bangkok. Nothing going on.
But the problem is that there is nothing to do in Bangkok except find hookers. I mean, like, what would you be purporting to do? You're there, be like, we're going on hikes. Like, what would you even say that you were
in
there?
In Bangkok? Bangkok has very exciting temple tours and...
custard places.
You got a custard place? Yeah.
You have your list.
Yeah.
There's a frozen yogurt place in Bangkok. If you're going to do all like Japan, you know all the places all around the world.
I do. I know frozen custard around the world. I'm the custard guy.
That's a likable quality.
Yeah, you know, it makes me non-threatening.
I like it.
It's misleading, though. I can still be quite threatening.
And I'm excited because I'm going to go see Chris Angel. I love magicians, so like I'm
what?
Gonna yeah no I love magicians I love magic so I'm gonna go see Chris Angel, which is kind of exciting.
No, it will be. Chris Angel's a very nice man, you know.
He wears
a bit of eyeliner, but
I was gonna say,
but he's good. He's been on the show. He's terribly nice and a very good magician. I won't say a word against him. I really won't, which is unusual for me, as you know.
Like hot, you know. I like magicians because now it's like you don't see like ugly magicians. Part of their whole thing is that they're like have their hair done and eyeliner.
Yeah, that makes somebody hot.
It shows effort.
They have their hair done and eyeliner, and you're like, ooh, take me to Vegas, baby.
My boyfriend's in Kiss.
Is he really?
No,
would be so great.
No, I just think it's so theatrical.
Does your boyfriend wear eyeliner?
No, my boyfriend doesn't wear eyeliner, no.
Does he have a mustache?
No, he does not.
Right.
Do you think... It's like you thought you might know him. The way you were asking all the specific questions.
I was calming it down. Yeah. I was like, does he wear eyeliner?
There's like a clock wipe 4 hours later. Getting closer.
Does he have a mustache? Is he French?
He's a mustachioed French. 3 minutes later, he's like, yeah, you know him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Pierre? Yeah. Yeah. Is he an actor?
He's an actor.
Really? Does he? How's his career going? Would we know him, or is he still working on getting to be known?
You will know him. He's on a reality punk to like prank show that's
What's
coming out
name?
On MTV.
Do you mind or are you?
No,
you guys...
his name is David Harris.
Oh, Dave Harris.
You know him. You guys are. He's going to Bangkok with you.
Yeah,
you
me and Dave are going to Bangkok this weekend. That's what he said. He said, "Look, I'll get my girlfriend to go to Vegas with the girls. We'll go to Bangkok for the boys' weekend." I'm like, okay.
I'm like allowed to be extremely angry with Craig if my boyfriend has sex with a woman in Bangkok this weekend. Okay? His fault.
Wait.
Thank you. Now I like you guys again. I like them again.
What do you mean? You're just falling into their web of deceit.
I'm so easily swayed.
Are you?
Yeah, I am. But so I'm going to... But I feel like when you go to Vegas, you have to like...
No, you don't have to do anything though. If you're serious about your relationship with this young man, you go there, you have a drink with your friends, but when it's time to leave the club, it's time to leave the club.
My grandfather.
Yes, I am.
I love this.
Yeah.
I think it's
I've decided that's the role I'm going to play. If you get closer, you'll notice I smell of vitamins and wee wee. Mindy, we're out of time. I have to go.
What?
We have to go. Yeah, I know.
Oh,
yeah.
Man. I had to
It was Mark Ruffalo with the yak, 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 and I.
That guy can talk.
And he can talk, yeah. He's hot, though, isn't he?
Didn't have enough makeup on.
Didn't have enough makeup on? I don't know. That beard is kind of hot. I like that.
He's a very handsome guy.
Yeah, he's handsome. We got to go.
Sorry. Oh. Yes. Thank you. Thanks
We're
for having
Mindy
me.
Kaling, everybody. We were right back. Welcome back. Listen. My next guests are great. They are a great band. Their folk rockers are here performing The Hazards of Love 2 from their album, The Hazards of Love. Give a big welcome to the Decemberists, everybody, the Decemberists.
And here I am, softer than a shower. Garland you with flowers to lay you down, clover bed. sky's roof above our head. And all my life I've never felt a tremor. And all my life it now disturbs.
Only CBS cares. And everyone else hates you. But I don't. I love you. In a very naughty way.
Hello, everyone.